more in the basic definition of C programming. And programming generally is the arc of communicating algorithms to computer. An algorithm is computational procedure whose steps are completely specified and elementary. As we saw, we have in our program hello.c, we have beginning with the hashtag include and a header file stdio.h, which is surrounded by angle bracket. And this means hashtag means you call a preprocessor. A preprocessor is in a library include, and it is stdio.h, which contains a lot of function, especially printf, which means print on frame. And the program, because we have a program.c, it must have a function, main function. You can write void main, void or int main, parentheses, and then bracket, and write hello world and return, because you have the main function, your main function has type integer, then you return zero. You must return. If it was void main void, then you didn't need any return function. And in this tutorial, I am going to talk more about variables. As you know, any program, to write a program, you need variables. And in the C, we have char as character, and it has signed char or unsigned char, depending on what kind of sign you are giving to your character. And we have integer, which is a usual number, and you have short integer or long integer, signed short integer, signed integer, or signed long integer. It means that you have a plus or minus values, and unsigned short integer, unsigned int, unsigned long int, or for decimal values, you have float, double or long double. All these variables has a fundamental space or bytes in the memory. That is because we use short or long if you, depending on what kind of program you make it, and you maybe doesn't need a 64 bits integer, and you are using short, which is few bits, and long is 64 bits. As the same way as for the character and the float and double. Float is a decimal value, which is which its bits are shorter than double, and double has longer. And when you are the characters in C. We have lowercase, we have uppercases, we have digits, we have another characters, and we have blank, new line, tab, etc. And the character constants is A to Z, lowercase, and its corresponding values in C, it's 97 to 112. And characters, constant characters, uppercase words, letters, they have corresponding values 65 to 90. And constant characters, like digits, they have corresponding value 48 to 57. And another constant characters, like other characters, they have another value. And you can find them simply in any ASCII table. In any ASCII table, you have decimal values 0 to 31, hexadecimal value 0 to 15 is 0 to F, and 10 is A, 11 B, 12 C, and so on. And then you begin after F, 10 until 19 and 1A, so on. And another value, the original value, characters or variables, begins from this decimal value 32, and it is a space, and it is a quotation mark, and it is quote, and it is a hashtag, dollars, and so on. And then the number 0 until 9, it is from 48 to 57, and colon, semicolon, less than, equal, bigger than, question mark, and at, sign, and uppercase A to Z, and another symbols, and lowercase A to Z, and also the rest of symbols. And for del, which is delete, you have the value 127, and the hexadecimal value is 7F. Also, ASCII table is built from 0 to 127, which is 2 up to 64. Something which is important is the special characters. When you want a bell, you write in your printf / A. / is / backspace is / B. Carriage return / R. Double quote is / quote. From feet / F. Horizontal tab / T, new line / N, null character / 0, single quote / single quote, vertical tab / V, and question mark backslash question mark. Then as we told, when you are using the integer values or variables, you use u as a suffix. When you use an integer, for example 37u, it means that it is unsigned integer. When you are using for long, you are using suffix l, for example 37l, which means it is long integer. And for unsigned long, you are using ul, and for float you are using f, and it must have a decimal value, at least a decimal value. We are going to go through later in the next tutorial. Okay, this is all in this tutorial. See you on next tutorial.